Hello friends, welcome to anujindal.in. So in today's video, I am going to discuss with you some important numerical questions from the topic of CVP analysis. CVP stands for cost, volume, profit. So you know in SEBI grade A examination in paper 2, you have 6 subjects and costing or cost accounting is one of those 6 subjects. So this video is really very important. Okay. And apart from that, if you want to gather information about the courses which we offer and about the details of SEBI grade A course, then you can visit our website www.anujindal.in. Or if you have any query or doubt, then you can call on 9999466225. You can call on this number or you can also write to us at info@anujindal.in. Okay. So if you have any query or any doubt, then you can either call us or you can also write to us. Now let us begin the session. So question 1, it says, if sales in an organization is rupees 1 lakh, fixed cost is given to you as rupees 12,000 and profit is given to you as rupees 8,000. Okay, you have to calculate the PV ratio. PV means profit volume ratio. And PV ratio is also called contribution sales ratio. Okay. So you are given sales, you are given fixed cost, and you are given profit. You have to calculate the PV ratio. Okay. So the options given to you are option A 80%, option B 8%, option C 20%, option D 12%, or is it option E 40%. Okay. So you have to calculate the PV ratio. Okay. Now sales are given to you as 1 lakh. Fixed cost is given to you as 12,000. And profit is given to you as 8,000. Now before calculating the PV ratio, you have to understand one thing. The concept of contribution. What is contribution? So contribution basically means sales minus variable cost. If you deduct the variable cost from the sales, then you get the contribution. Okay. And you can also calculate the contribution per unit, right? Apart from that, there is another formula to calculate contribution, which is fixed cost plus profit. So basically you can say that sales minus variable cost is equal to fixed cost plus profit, right? So in this particular question, we are given fixed cost and we are also given profit. So we can easily calculate the PV ratio. So the formula of PV ratio is contribution upon sales into 100. This is the formula to calculate the PV ratio. So we are being given contribution, or we can calculate the contribution as fixed cost plus profit, right? Fixed cost is given to us as 12,000 and profit is given to us as 8,000. And what is the sales? Sales is given to us as rupees 1 lakh. So this comes out to be 20,000 in the numerator, 1 lakh in the denominator multiplied by 100, because the value has to be calculated in the percentage. So this will come out to be 20%, right? So the correct answer will be option C, 20%. PV ratio is 20%. I hope this is very, very clear to you. So now we can move on to the next question. Question number 2. So fixed cost is given to you as rupees 2 lakhs. Sales is given to you as rupees 8 lakhs. And PV ratio is given to you as 30%. You have to calculate the amount of profit. Okay. So fixed cost is given, sales is given, and PV ratio is given. You have to calculate the amount of profit. So the options are option A 50,000, option B 40,000, option C 35,000, option D 45,000, or is it option E 30,000. Okay. So fixed cost is given to us as 2 lakhs. Sales is given to us as 8 lakhs and PV ratio is given to us as 30%, right? Now, what is the meaning of this 30% PV ratio? This basically means if you calculate the 30% of sales, then you will get the contribution amount. If you multiply this 30% PV ratio with the sales value, then you will get the contribution amount. This you have to remember, okay? So 30% of sales, which is 8 lakhs, this comes out to be rupees 2,40,000. Okay, this will come out to be rupees 2,40,000. Now you can easily calculate the amount of profit. As I told you in the previous question, contribution is equal to sales minus variable cost or fixed cost plus profit, both. Okay, so contribution we have calculated as 2,40,000, right? Fixed cost is given to us as 2 lakh. Now we can easily calculate the profit, right? So from this equation, you can easily calculate the profit. So the profit will be rupees 40,000. I hope it is very, very clear to you. So the correct answer will be option B, rupees 40,000. So this equation of contribution is very, very important to remember. So contribution is equal to sales minus variable cost, and contribution is also equal to fixed cost plus profit, right? Now let us move to the next question, question number 3. So the question says a product is sold at a price of rupees 120 per unit and its variable cost is rupees 80 per unit. Okay, so you are given selling price per unit and you are given variable cost per unit. The fixed expenses of the business are rupees 8,000 per year. You are also given the fixed cost, right? You have to calculate the break-even point in rupees. Now, this is very, very important. What is break-even point? Break-even point is that point where there is no profit, no loss. Okay, neither there is profit nor there is loss. So it is that level of sales at which the company is neither earning any profit nor it is incurring any loss, right? So break-even point can be calculated in units also, and it can be calculated in rupees also. Okay, so the formula for units and the formula for rupees is different, right? There is a slight difference. Now the options given to you are option A, rupees 12,000. Option B, rupees 24,000. Option C, rupees 16,000. Option D, rupees 18,000. Or is it option E, rupees 8,000? These are the options given to you. Now we are given selling price per unit as rupees 120. We are given variable cost per unit as rupees 80, and fixed cost is given to you as 8,000, right? Now, what is the formula to calculate the break-even point in terms of rupees? So the formula is break-even point in terms of rupees is equal to fixed cost upon PV ratio. This is the formula, right? So fixed cost is given to us. We need to calculate the PV ratio. So PV ratio, as I told you, it will be selling price per unit, which is 120, minus variable cost per unit, which is 80, multiplied by the selling price, which is again 120. So sales minus variable cost upon sales. So this can be the formula, or it can also be per unit basis. Okay, the answer will remain same. Either you calculate it on per unit basis, or you take the total sales value and the total variable cost, PV ratio will remain the same, right? So it will be 40 upon 120 into 100. So this comes out to be 1 by 3 into 100, which is 33 1 by 3%. So the PV ratio comes out to be 33 1 by 3%. I hope this is very, very clear to you. So now we can calculate the break-even point. Now there is no problem. Just substitute the values in the formula and you will get the answer. So break-even point is equal to fixed cost given to you as 8000 rupees and PV ratio is 33 1 by 3%, which can also be written as 1 by 3. 33 1 by 3% can also be written as 1 by 3, right? So break even point will come out to be rupees 24,000. This will come out to be rupees 24,000. I hope this question is very, very clear to you. So the correct answer will be option B, rupees 24,000, right? Now we can move on to the next question. Question 4. So the question says, a product is sold at a price of rupees 120 per unit and its variable cost is given to you as 80 per unit, right? The fixed expenses of the business are rupees 8,000 per year. So much of the information is same as it was in the previous question, but the only difference is that in this particular question, you have to calculate the sales to be made to earn a net profit of rupees 5,000 for the year. Okay, so you are given selling price per unit, you are given variable cost per unit, and you are given fixed cost. Now you need to calculate the sales to be made so that the company or the firm earns a profit of 5,000. Okay, so the options given to you are option A, rupees 33,000, option B, rupees 40,000, option C, rupees 36,000, option D, rupees 42,000, or is it option E, rupees 39,000. So these are the options given to us. Now how to do this question? So the formula to calculate the sales is equal to fixed cost plus required profit divided by the PV ratio. So if you will look at this formula is very similar to the formula to calculate break-even point. So in the previous question, we calculated the break-even point, and in that particular question, we divided the fixed cost by the PV ratio. Now we are being given that the required profit is 5,000. So simply we will add this profit figure in the numerator. That's it. This is the only difference. Okay. So the sales which have to be made to earn a profit of 5,000 will be fixed cost. It is given to us as rupees 8,000. Required profit is given to us as rupees 5,000. And PV ratio, as we calculated in the previous question, it was 1 by 3, right? So sales will be equal to 13,000 divided by 1 by 3, which will come out to be rupees 39,000. So sales of rupees 39,000 have to be made to earn a profit of 5,000. So the correct answer is option E, rupees 39,000. I hope this is very, very clear to you. Now let us move to the last question for this video. So the question says, selling price of a product is rupees 32 per unit and variable cost ratio is given to you as 50%. Okay, fixed cost is given to you as rupees 96,000. Units sold are given to you as 10,000, right? You have to calculate the margin of safety in percentage terms. Okay, so you have to calculate margin of safety in percentage terms. So what are the options given to you? Options are option A 40%, option B 60%, option C 50%, option D 30%, or it cannot be determined, right? Now the information given to you is selling price per unit, which is 32. Variable cost is given to you in percentage terms, which is 50%, and fixed cost is given to you as 96,000, right? And units sold are given to you as 10,000. This is the information being provided to you. Now you need to understand what is the meaning of margin of safety. So margin of safety is actual sales minus the break-even sales, right? This is the meaning of margin of safety. So sales over and above the break-even point is called the margin of safety. So this can be in rupees also and this can be in units also. Now in this question, you are given selling price per unit, you are given variable cost as 50%. This 50% means 50% of sales, right? So 50% of sales or 50% of selling price per unit. So selling price is given to you as 32. So variable cost per unit will be half of 32, which will be rupees 16 per unit, right? And fixed cost is given to you as rupees 96,000 and units are 10,000. So first of all, as I told you the formula of margin of safety, so we are having actual sales, but we do not have the break-even sales. So first of all, we need to calculate the break-even point in units term, okay? We need the break-even point in units term. And what is the formula to calculate the break-even point in units term? It is fixed cost divided by contribution per unit, right? So if break-even point has to be calculated in rupees, then our denominator is PV ratio. But if break-even point has to be calculated in units, then our denominator is contribution per unit, right? So what will be the contribution per unit? So contribution per unit, it will be selling price per unit, which is 32, minus variable cost per unit, which is 16. So our contribution per unit comes out to be 16 rupees, okay? Now we can calculate the break-even point. So break-even point will be fixed cost, which is 96,000, divided by contribution per unit, which is 16. So our break-even point comes out to be 6,000 units. Our break-even point comes out to be 6,000 units. Now we can calculate the margin of safety. So margin of safety, as I told you, it is actual sales minus break-even sales. So margin of safety means actual sales, which is 10,000, minus break-even sales, which is 6,000. So margin of safety comes out to be 4,000 units, right? But in the question, we are being asked that we have to calculate the margin of safety in percentage terms. So margin of safety in percentage terms will be simply margin of safety divided by the units sold, okay? So margin of safety divided by the units sold, this will be equal to 4,000 units divided by 10,000 units into 100, because it has to be calculated in percentage. So this will come out to be 40%. This will come out to be 40%, okay? So the correct answer will be option A, 40%. I hope this is very, very clear to you. So friends, I hope you must have liked this video, as I have tried to cover the different topics from the area of CVP analysis. So CVP analysis is very, very important and you should remember every formula. So there are a lot of formulas in this particular topic. So you must know each and every formula and you should also understand them, because only mugging them up will not help. Okay. So friends, if you have liked this video, then do subscribe to our channel and also hit the bell icon to get regular notifications and updates. If you have any query or doubt, then you can post your query in the comment section below. So all the very best friends, prepare hard, have a nice day.